Hey babe, so you've been trying to figure out why you can't start. You've been trying to understand why you haven't started your journey, why you haven't been able to get to the next step, why you're still not an influencer, you're still not an entrepreneur, why you still haven't started college, why you still haven't became that girl. Well, I'm here to tell you, it happens to the best of us. Like, no, you're not the reason why. Like, it's only because you don't have tools. Like, as long as you put yourself in a place of having tools and having things together and having direction, then you'll be able to start. Okay, so let's go over daily habits for success. And you may see me look down a little bit because these are my notes. I'm trying to stay on track so we can go over this really quick, really fast, so you can get the tools that you need so you can start today. No more excuses. So for you to be successful, it may seem like it's not realistic at this point, right? You have been searching, you have been researching, and you just have not found the thing that actually sticks. Well, honestly, let's go over the five things that will stick and you will start today and you will allow it to be part of your life. That's one thing you have to remember. You have to get to the point of realizing, like, hey, this is my life now. This is realistic. This is me. You have to jot it down, okay? So get your notes. Let's get started. Step one. When you want to start a better life and have a successful habits for your success, right? You want to have a morning routine. Having a morning routine will just set up your day for success, period. You either getting up and stretching, journaling, listen to affirmations, anything like that. Like, just getting up and starting and putting your brain on what you're trying to get accomplished that day will only help. Journaling, you can write about what you're grateful for. Journaling, you can talk about the new you. Like, you can really, like, write out your story and then just start being that person you're writing out. No more excuses. You can do it. Let's get to it. Come on. So, step two, right? When after you do your morning routine, right, you should also, like, within your morning routine, have some type of priorities you got to get attached, like setting up a to-do list, like making sure that you understand the things that you need to do. So this involves doing some type of research and things like that, understanding the steps you need to take so you can start whatever you're trying to start. So do your research, set up your priorities, set up the things that you need to focus on. If your brain goes left and right and left and this, you set up a long list of unrealistic tasks, you will not be able to complete the task for the day. So just remember, when you are setting up your priorities and setting up your to-do list, it's actually realistic for that day. So you can't exactly get 1,000 followers in one day. Don't put that on your to-do list for that day. Do not overwhelm yourself. Do not do that to yourself. Please. There's no need for that. Relax. Let's get to it. Like, let's understand what's best for us and let's move in that direction. Don't try to set up things that don't make sense for your life. Step three is consistency over perfection. So making sure that you're actually doing the thing instead of perfecting it. Like, if you do something again and again, you will only become better at what you're doing. So remember, practice makes better. So as long as you are practicing to post that content, or as long as you're practicing to apply to that job every day, or as long as you're practicing for that interview, like, if you are practicing for the things that you're trying to get accomplished, it would only happen for it. Like, if you put yourself in that space of being successful, how would it not happen? Come on. Let's think about it. Like, think about it. Right now, you're probably not doing anything. You're probably just talking about it and then just doing your regular life. I bet you haven't opened up that book to figure out how to do it. I bet you haven't actually applied to the job. I bet you haven't even did no type of research to even figure out how to do it. Yeah. I don't want to hear no more. Please. Okay. But anyway, so step four, make sure you're eating healthy. Like, understand your body has to be at peace so you can actually accomplish the goals that you want to accomplish? Like, how are you going to be able to do the things that you want to do when you're not, your body's not even in a place to do it? Like, if you are eating unhealthy, it will only keep you in a sick place. Like, you, because right now, if you're on your grind mode, more than likely you'll probably get a little less sleep. But make sure you're still getting sleep, though. If you get a little less sleep, then that means you need the nutrients you need to be able to continue on with what you're doing. Having a healthy lifestyle, like exercising, only helps you mentally and things like that. Like, making sure that you have healthy habits will only allow you to be the best person you could be. Stop trying to do everything when you know you need to be doing just this. Like, think about things that's actually going to help you in the long run instead of just assuming that, oh, if I go out to the club every night and drink a little bit, I just have one or two drinks, it's okay. No. You going out and drinking is only making yourself tired. How are you going to be able to do the things you want to do if you're always tired? Answer that. Yeah, I'll wait. Yeah, I thought so. But anyways, so step five. Avoiding distractions. Ooh, goes to what I was just saying about the healthy habits. Like, staying on track and working out and eating the right things for yourself only makes sense. But if you go off and go to the club and do things that don't align with what you're trying to do right now, it will only allow you to backtrack and go back to what you used to be. Go back to your comfortable place. Like, you don't need that. I promise, you don't need that. You need to be going towards new and better things so you can align yourself with the goals that you want to accomplish, the things on your priority list that you know that you need to get accomplished. I'm pretty sure going to the club is not on your priority list. I know for sure it's not. So let's not do that. Let's think about things that's actually good for us and that's going to motivate us and push us to the next limit. Okay, so far we got morning routine, setting priorities, consistency over perfection, and then we also have healthy habits, and now, well, we just did avoiding distractions, and then number six would be the end of the day reflection. Like, each day after your day, if you go and sit and just think about everything that you have accomplished, and you celebrate your wins, and you remind yourself that you are doing amazing, it will only make you want to do it more. You'll be like, oh my gosh, I can't wait for this part of the day. I get to talk about and rave about everything I've been doing today. And you get to analyze everything you did. So if you did something wrong, you'd be like, okay, I know I did that, so I need to correct that. I know I ate this bad thing, but if you are able to advise yourself of what you did wrong compared to not even talking about it at all, it will get you to a better place. So you will, it will force you throughout the day to do be better, you know, like it will allow you to be in the place that you want to be instead of just going day by day and not actually talking to yourself. Talking to yourself is key. Like, if you talk to yourself, you're gonna allow yourself to realize, like, okay, I'm not that bad of a person, but I could have did this and this and this. And it just helps you when it comes to, like, organizing your thoughts and making sure that the things that you're doing only make sense, right? And all of this only keeps you on track for your long-term growth. Like, when you are analyzing and making sure that, okay, I did the things that you didn't do, it just helps you in the long run, because then you're getting to a point of being able to be your, like, coach, your own coach. Like, you're coaching yourself to be the better. Be that person for yourself. If you don't actually start doing the things for yourself that you want people to do for you, you would never get to the place that you want to be. Don't expect people to be a certain way when you're not even treating yourself good. If you don't tell yourself yes or no or things like that that makes sense of what you actually want to do, you will never have trust within yourself. So how will you be able to accomplish the goals that you want to accomplish when you're not actually protecting yourself and you're not actually doing the things that you make yourself feel love? Making yourself feel love is important when you come to, like, becoming a new you. So, y'all, all of this comes back to make sure you are setting yourself up for success and actually do daily tasks that make sense for your life. Make sure the daily tasks that you're doing so you can complete the day aligns with your goals and your priorities and things like that. Don't keep coming looking for a video on YouTube and don't actually take initiative on it. make sure you're actually going through the tasks and doing the things that you need to do so you can get to where you want to be. Let's not wait no more. Let's actually start today. Bye, babe.